And as you can see, the ref's throwing the first flag right here on them in the early in the first quarter here. So we're going to have an extra man by Grand Valley State at 10-12 left in the first quarter.
That's going to be it's going to be their Achilles heel, just like Coach Cummings had said, Coach Barrett, that you can't afford in these tournaments to spend 5-6 minutes in the penalty box. It's just there's no way you can come out of these games winning when you're playing man down a third of a game.
I want to say thank you to our sponsors, Laxworld and the City of Greenville, putting on this great tournament. We got six fields here, Division I, Division II, MCLA National Championship Tournament. We're in the first round here, opening day.
Nice shot by Shane Harrison. Went wide right over the cage.
Shot.
Wow.
Goal There's by Grand Valley ties it up at one. Great shot by number zero, Charlie Farmer. Charlie has a brother, Tyler, both big midfielders on this Grand Valley State team. Charlie and Tyler Farmer, and Charlie hits his first shot there. Charlie's a transfer from High Point University Division I school in North Carolina. So he's back home in Michigan playing for the Grand Valley State team here. Winner of this game will play the winner of number 3 St. John's and number 14 Western Oregon tomorrow. So this is a big matchup here. Winner moves on, loser goes home.
You know what stood out about that shot, Coach Barrett? It just like Coach Murray had said, he didn't try to break the back of the net on that one. He sidearm shot, but he put it right where he needed to shoot, and that's the sign of a good marksman right there.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's one of the things the coach was talking about. We want to shoot for net, shoot for open space, and not just throw it at the goal, and that's what they did, and now it's tied up 1-1 with 9:21 left in this first quarter here. We had an early possession call from the referee. It's going to go alternate possession. So white ball here and alternate possession, so that means the next time we have an alternate possession, it'll be black ball with SCAD. SCAD coached by Coach Cummings. Grand Valley State coached by Coach Murray. Coach Murray going in his third year. All 3 years they've been in the tournament. And this is SCAD's fourth appearance in the Big Dance.
What's the advantage here, Coach Barrett, for SCAD coming up from Georgia, not probably, but about 2.5 hour drive?
Yeah, I think that's a big advantage when it comes to travel, because you got Grand Valley State coming all the way from the Grand Rapids, Michigan, and you got SCAD just really coming up I-85 a couple hours right here to Greenville. So shorter travel. We'll see if that plays into effect here later in the game when it comes down to stamina. Great interception by number 10. On SCAD to take the ball back. That's Shelton. Great player. SCAD looks to him to be one of the big players here in this game. Here comes number 18. Ball's down. Ball's up. And we're going back the other way. Grand Valley.
Yeah.
So we have a 6-on-4 situation here for Grand Valley. They push it. Big shot from up top and a save.
Great save.
Would have liked to have seen a little bit more ball movement there to attack that transition. But we're coming right back down. SCAD's ball here. Shelton with the ball, number 10.
Creighton Polka didn't even bite a bit on that one, Coach Barry. He has hit his stick high, and he saw it all the way. Didn't dip one bit, just to let that ball come right to him.
What a beautiful day here in Greenville, South Carolina. What a great day for lacrosse. Probably a similar atmosphere to when these two met early in the year in Florida. Sun's out, grass is green. Just great day for lacrosse. Ball moving around the SCAD offense here, looking for their matchup. Ball's up top of number 18. 18 might have been on the all-flow team, Coach Duran, with that hair. What a great assist to go along with that flow.
Great assist. Cody Sikinowicz with the goal, but what an assist by number number 18, Sean Hornsey.
Sean just gets himself to the middle of the field, draws a slide, bangs it one more. I mean, Sean's got great size. He looks like he's 6'2", 6'3", out there, dodging from the midfield. That's a handful.
He's got the flow, too. You're right. He's definitely
he's on the all-flow team. Check out Inside the Cross next year. I guarantee he's Sean's on there. 2-1 SCAD. 2-1 SCAD. Face-offs out in front. Moving towards the SCAD attack.
Well, getting a little physical
over there.
Ball
be out of bounds. SCAD ball. You're right, Coach. It is getting physical. Every loose ball is a battle right here, right now. And that's what you expect in the national championship tournament.
Yeah, I don't think anybody wants it. That's
big shot up top from the long pole, number 31. Easy save for 21, the goalie in Grand Valley. He's setting up there clear now. Ball gets thrown to an open middie opposite the box. Easy clear for Grand Valley, and he's pushing it. Ball down to the attack, up to the wing here for number 12. Number 12's got great size too, Coach Duran.
Yeah, there are some really, really large guys out here, and some of the stick handling for Grand Rapids. Like, we got some lefties out here that are really, really crafty with the ball. And the farmer boys are actually outstanding players.
It's 2-1 SCAD, but Grand Valley has had the ball almost this entire game. When SCAD has brought it down, they've scored two quick goals. So, hey, if you can score as soon as you have it, might as well do it and just let the other team play with the ball as long as they can here, as long as you have the lead.
That's what Coach Cummings said he wanted. He wanted transition. He's got transition. You know, the counter punch of that is how much can you do before your defense starts to break down.
Here comes big ISO dodge from number 12. Gets a pick at X. Spins off of it back to his right hand. Good defense right here by the SCAD defender. Great check by number 16, Cody. What a great check by Cody, one of their best defenders. Coach is talking about him before the game, says he's going to be one to watch today. Ball gets in the stick of the short stick here. Moves it up to number 16.
Helps to have friends.
Ladder right up the side. Easy clear for SCAD.
A little bit different here with the riding and clearing situation than we saw last game. Last game we saw, I think both teams felt that each team's weakness was the clearing game, and both were trying to really pressure it. It looks like these two teams respect each other's transition games.
Yeah, absolutely.
Coach,
I mean, it's funny because you talk to Coach Cummings, a SCAD coach, and he said he wants to push transition. It's almost like Coach Murray was standing right next to us when he said that, because they just keep dropping in the hole.
Absolutely.
And they're not allowing it. Shot goes wide right now. It's dribbling out. Ground ball picked up by Grand Valley outside in the corner here.
Absolutely outworked to that ball, too.
Tiptoeing that sideline. Gets it back into the goalie. And here comes Grand Valley on their clear.
Great hustle by Brendan O'Donnell to that ball and just really, really out-hustled his guy.
Aaron pass out of bounds. It's going to go back to SCAD on a quick restart here.
We got no ball for a quick restart, unfortunately.
They really need to get a couple more balls in the box. That's the new rule this year. There should be balls all across the sideline and end line so that we can start these quick restarts now, especially with the new five-yard rule. Got to give a player 5 yards.
Good defense there by number 18 from Grand Valley, Ryan Farley. I love to see little defensive midfielders that are aggressive like that, get down on guys' hips and really drive guys away. That's just one of the aspects of the game that gets overlooked too often, Coach. And there's nothing like having those workers out there that are willing to get out there and grind it out and just play hard
absolutely.
Man defense.
I mean, those are probably the most, you know, unknown guys on the team, but do all the dirty work. You know, their name's not in the paper for the goals, but they're the ones getting the clear and getting it down to those guys.
And what a great save by Keaton Polka again. It was a doorstep shot and soaked up another one. Unfortunately, SCAD just turned the ball over again.
So Grand Valley yelling. Well, both teams just throwing the ball away. Still, still early game, first quarter jitters here, and both teams just no pressure on them, throwing the ball away, and now we're going to come back with a SCAD clear here. Getting it up to the short stick middie, number 18, who looks to leg it over the midfield.
He's a big guy.
Assisted by number 22, Daniel Caselli. Williams from Caselli at 5:22 in the first quarter.
Ball's up to number 7, gets it worked down to 13 on the attack, back up to 7. Moves it up to 32, and looks like he's going to take a hard alley dodge here. Coming to his left first, stops, comes back to his right. Cutter in front. Aaron, he missed the pass, and here comes ball down, and Grand Valley State's pushing it. It's 5-on-4 at the point.
Right now. A little slow break from behind. They moved that ball quick enough. They got a man coming streaking from the box right now, wide open, and they missed him.
So Grand Valley State just settles the ball down, gets their offense back on. 2-1 SCAD here in the opening quarter. 2:40 left in the first quarter here in Greenville, South Carolina.
It feels like a six-five, six-six type of game right now, the way they've been getting up and down the field, Coach. Just nobody's been able to put the ball in the back.
I have a feeling there'll be some more goals later on in this game, especially with a 17-11 first time these two met. You know, that's 28 goals. So right now we got 3, so we got a little bit of ways to catch up to that first meeting.
That is great math on the spot, Coach Barrett. A limestone degree paid off.
It did. It did. Thank you, Sister Mary Malden. Here comes a big dodge from Grand Valley State, number 11 up top. Stays to his right hand, pushes it down the side, the 19. Back up top, there's a timer on. Timer on call here on Grand Valley. Still, timer is still on, So it's the invisible shot clock. 30-second shot clock, so the refs have a 20-second beeper on their hip. Once that goes off, then it's a 10 count on the hand. Cut inside, so now the 10 count has started. Scat's ball now. Feet inside. Big
great
save by the Scat goalie.
Boy, oh boy.
Shot gets chased out, and it's going to stay with White.
Polka, again, just comes up huge. That's his third or fourth just one-on-one save. And he's just stealing guys' cookies right now.
You need a goalie in the playoffs, absolutely. Ball gets swung up top of Grand Valley. Looks like they're in that 21 set. Two attack behind, one in the crease, 3 middies, and an umbrella up top. Aaron Pass, number 11, stays with it. Gets himself in the middle of the field. Check, ball's down. Grand Valley comes back away with it.
That's
a lot of stick checks so far, Coach Duran.
Yeah, a lot of stick and not a lot of body. I'm kind of more along the lines of a 50-50 guy.
That was a great dodge. They had a near man slide, fed it down to the low left attackman who just shot it wide, and we're going SCAD ball here.
That was unusual because dive looked like it came a little early for the where the ball went out of bounds, but nevertheless, SCAD's in transition anyway again. So this has been an up and down game, exciting to watch for sure.
Here's a little bit more riding going on. It looks like Grand Valley come away with it at the midfield line. Here comes long pole number 17. Push it down to the left-handed attackman, who catches it, and that'll be the end of the quarter. 2-1 SCAD after quarter number 1, live from the MCLA Division II National Championship first-round matchup with Grand Valley State and SCAD. SCAD leading 2-1. We will be back in a moment.
lot of balls come out of that corner and come down that hard and out straight that don't actually go into that part of the net. But when those shots are moving that fast, that's a 90-mile-an-hour shot right there. It's pretty tough for referee to see.
SCAD clearing it into their offensive end. A lot of pressure from Grand Valley. They actually take the ball off and get it to their goalie, and now they're back on the clear. Grand Valley taking their time. Goalie walking it up, throws it over the midfield line to a streaking midfielder, and that's number 18 catching it, getting down the side, get it to the attackman number 12, back up to zero.
Ball gets up to number 9.
And Grand Valley's back on the offensive end. Doing a nice job subbing, getting their guys on, and going hard at the goal. Here comes number 1. Back up top to number 9. Sweeping hard to his left hand, driving in, big shot. Shot gets chased, and it's going to SCAD.
Yeah,
great job on the backup by the defenseman for SCAD. Quick restart. They get it to number 10 in the midfield, and he's going to leg it out. So here comes SCAD back on the offensive end here. Let's see if they can get a little bit of possession here. Again, it's 2-1 SCAD. Ball has been really dominated by Grand Valley State, but SCAD just has one more in the back of the net than Grand Valley does so far.
Goal scorer number 22, Daniel Caselli. Caselli unassisted at 14:28 of the second quarter.
SCAD moving it around their offensive end. Ball gets to number 13, up top to number 18.
Grand Valley's got to watch it here. They're starting to get themselves a little too far out, pressuring out on their guys.
Here comes
guys.
Number 7, quick dodge, beats his man, shot. Wide, backup goes to SCAD. Turnover by the SCAD Bees, and we're going back to White. White on the clear. Grand Valley with the ball, and here comes the restart.
Time to go 14-10 of the second quarter. Pat Cordia calls timeout.
Short stick with the ball, number 9. He's going to take on his attackman, get it over the midfield line here for a clear. They're going to get a touch in the box. Ball gets down the side. Over to X. Back up to the lefty wing, number 42 with the ball, gets it back up top. So they're just spinning it around the offense right now, getting their offensive subs on. And now they'll be ready to attack. Both goaltenders putting good performances out there so far, Coach Turin.
Yeah, they both really have come up big, especially Polk from SCAD. I mean, I think we said before, he's up to 4 or 5 doorstep saves. Outside shots, he got tested.
Just an errant pass again by Grand Valley. Just throws the ball away, no pressure. So we're going to come back the other way with the clear with SCAD. And they get it to number 10. Ball gets over to 16.
He got a shorty right next to him.
He carries it up, gets it to the attack. Gets a touch in the box. So SCAD with the ball is being pressured all the way at the midfield line here. Gets a pass off.
I want to attack right now, Coach. If I'm SCAD, I got guys spread out all over the place. I just want to dodge somewhere.
Yep, best time to go at the defense is when they're not ready. So there's a shot quick off the left wing there. SCAD with the backup.
Here comes a quick dodge and a pick at X off the end line. Number 2 keeping it in his left hand, keeps driving too hard to his left, moves it up top. Over to 18. Dodging hard to his right hand, stops at the top of the box, continues back to his right hand, jump shot, hits the pipe,
come
back out, and it's going to be SCAD ball off the shot.
Just an unfortunate pipe for Sean Hornsby. That was that shot had goal written all over it.
Dodge, falls to his ground, no call there for the refs, ball's loose. We have a loose ball top of the box. SCAD picks it up. SCAD puts it up again. They got the loose ball. So they recover again.
I tell
you. 2-1, 9:18 left in the second quarter here.
Coach Bear, I love the hustle from this Polka, Sheldon Polka.
Absolutely. Sheldon's been clearing the ball, comes around hard, left-handed, takes a shot wide. Backup goes to SCAD. Yeah, I mean, Coach, he's been clearing it. He's been playing defense. He's been dodging. So he's just looking to find the back of the net here to finish this hole off.
Yeah, he's been a one-man machine in there. You know, they've now shifted the pole to him where they didn't have the pole on him before. He's a good player, and like you said, he's a jack of all trades right now, which you love to see in a kid.
Ball's up top with SCAD, coming hard down the alley. Number 18, shot. Great save by the goalkeeper. Gets his own rebound, comes in front with a jump shot, but lands in the crease, and it's going back to Grand Valley State on the clear.
Little unorthodox, but he's getting to the cage. And
there's a flag.
So we got a delay of game on SCAD. It looks like.
So we're going to have an extra man here for Grand Valley State. Looks like the SCAD kid threw the ball a little bit too far away for the referee's liking. They gave him a delay of game, so that should be a 30-second foul. And now we have an extra man opportunity for Grand Valley to see if they can tie this game, Coach.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see the first man up of the day between these two teams. A lot of pressure early. Sometimes that can throw off your man up. Sometimes it leaves that backside open like it is right now.
So moving the ball around in a 3-3. Number 12, Aaron Pass, picks it up off the ground. Number 11, moves it to number 1. Big shot and sticks the corner. Wow. What an unbelievable shot.
Connor
by number
Schwalm
1.
Has an absolute hand cannon.
Absolutely. That was a great shot. Stuck the top corner. Hit pipe to pipe. That makes it a 2-2 ball game here. 8:11 left in the second quarter, 2-2. In the first round of the Division II MCLA National Championship game.
He just earned that one off the pipe pack, coaches. The one that got taken away, he just earned that one back with a double corner pipe. That was no question that one was in.
Again,
that was
the winner
heavy
of this
heat.
Game will play the winner of number 3 St. John's and number 14 Western Oregon in the second round. SCAD coming back with the ball off the faceoff. Quick shot. Another save by the goalie at Grand Valley State. Ground ball picked up in the corner. Grand Valley State gets out of trouble. He's carrying it up the field. Beats two more attackmen. Gets it over to the other side of the field here. Changes fields. Back to the goalie. Now they're going to set up their clear.
That's a dangerous pass for a goalie.
So good clear by Grand Valley. They have the ball down on their offensive end. 2-2 game with about 7 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Low scoring affair so far, and that's partly due because of both goalies making outstanding saves so far here.
First line midfield out here again for Grand Valley State. And if you're SCAD right now, you're playing this midfield out hard. They got two guys that can really bring the heat.
Yeah, if I'm Grand Valley right now, I'm looking to dodge, and let's see if I can get another time and room shot for number 1 here. He really has a great shot. Good defense by SCAD, getting the ball down back to the goalie, and they're looking to clear it up their way now. Big ride by Grand Valley State on his butt end, hacking him.
Boy.
He clears it over the midfield line with no trouble.
Laying the lumber there. I'm surprised that the trail ref right there didn't get him for that one.
Yeah, I think maybe one more whack and he would have had a slash there, but they kind of let him play. They're letting him play today. It's playoff atmosphere here. And, wide open man in the middle of the crease for SCAD. He can't handle it. He gets it back out. Open guy on backside. Great save by the Grand Valley State goalie again.
Right, boy, that was just great, great closeout defense by Farmer.
Here comes SCAD on the offensive side again, retaining the ball. Under 6 minutes to play here in the second quarter. Dodge hard, number 7, coming down the alley. Moves it to X. comes back the same way it came from with the lefty attackman. Moves it. Bad pass inside. We got a fast break coming the other way. Grand Valley. Yeah, that's number one with the ball.
Four on three
they set
right
up
now.
A lefty break, and it's an errant feed going number four. Just missed the pass, and it goes out of bounds going back up to SCAD. Tough play right there.
Yeah, it's tough to see when you know you don't see a lot of true 4-on-3 fast breaks in college lacrosse anymore. Just people, athletes against athletes right now. That most teams got a defensive guy or an offensive guy that can match feet and get in the hole. So you really got to take advantage of those situations.
SCAD having trouble in the clear.
Practice them and you wait for them and you may get one or two a game.
SCAD's got to get a touch in the box here fast, and they do. So SCAD back on offense here. What a game so far. 2-2. Both goalies standing on their head, making great doorstep saves. Offenses are moving the ball, finding open guys, just having trouble hitting the back of the net right now. So here's SCAD with the ball. Four minutes, 40 seconds left in the second quarter. Number 18, big top dodge to his right hand. Stops at the top of the box. Moves it back to 32. Having trouble handling.
I'd like to see him.
And the
keep
ball
that
gets back down to the attack for Grand Valley, and he's
Look
taking it to the goal here.
Great hustle by number four.
Tough feed. Goalie's out of the cage. Feed in front, and that goes wide.
Here comes a man coming out of the box. He was able to pick up the ball on the sub. So
late
ball stays at Grand Valley.
Late substitution works to their favor on that one.
He's got an invert here. Number 19 going to the goal hard. Picks it up to number 12. Great save by the SCAD goalkeeper.
Picked up by Grand Valley. Under 4 minutes to play in the first half.
Grand Valley working the ball around their offense. Grand Valley getting it down the X. They got the invert matchup they like against number 18. 26 dodging hard to his right hand. He's got a step, moves it up. Up to number 12, gets it to four, can't handle. Comes inside with it, picks, smacking around off the ground. Number 19 picks it up off the ground, takes it to X. Looking to come around hard right hand, it comes back to his left.
Smart decision. Smart decision, he was gonna pull the trigger, he pulled back and saw they didn't have anything there and reset the offense and let's play again.
Grand Valley really dodging from behind out of this invert, moving it up top to number 12. Up back up to four. Looks like Grand Valley, when they get out of their invert right now, too many guys standing too close to each other. They got guys rotating to the same spot. So the timer on here, they go back to the invert. Dodging from behind, comes underneath, feeds in front. We got a crease violation, we're going SCAD ball. Clock is still running. Okay, clock stopped now, 2:41 here in the second quarter. SCAD's ball on their end, they gotta clear it. Two down ride right now for Grand Valley. Now they drop, so they're in a one down. Long pole open in the middle of the field. Butt end check, Grand Valley picks it up. They push it down to number 12, shot wide.
Boy, oh boy.
And that's going to go black ball, no backup.
Boy, oh boy, that's just one of those ones, coach. They just break you. They break you as a coach and as a player because you.
Yeah, you want that one back. Yeah, that's right there. You're standing at 7 yards, hands free.
Got dollar signs.
Here comes number 18 on the clear. Big, tall, right-handed kid. Okay, throws the ball away here. Ball's loose in the corner. Nice hockey by a defenseman. Hockey's it to his teammate here. They redirect fields, and now they're looking to clear it up the box sideline. Gets it to the attackman here, number four, Grand Valley State. Under 2 minutes to play in the first half, we have a 2-2 game. So very different from the first meeting when they played 17-11 down in Florida. Second, third week of the season here, and now we got a 2-2 game in the playoffs. So I would say the coaches watched a little film, coach, and probably got some differences that they wanted to do and some things they didn't like or things they did like, and now you got a 2-2 game.
Yeah, a lot changes in 12 weeks. That's what a great save by Polka again. It can't be a coincidence that his brother's a great shooter and he's a great goalie, because the two of them are really, really outstanding players.
There's another Aaron Clare by Savannah. They throw it away, and we're coming right back with Grand Valley State. A lot of turnovers here in the middle of the field, especially in the clearing game. I know Coach Cummings is would like a little bit of a difference here. Fifty-nine seconds getting put back up on the clock. It's still running down here. Clock's still running for whatever reason. They're trying to get it back to 59 seconds. It reads 26 right now. So they got
to
throw 33
game,
seconds
coach,
back on there.
We got 1 minute left. Do you come down, take your timeout, set something up?
I believe he still has a timeout. I would try to get a touch in the box, and I'd try to run a set play, you know, see if I can get something from one of my better middies or attackmen coming off, seeing if we can get a quick shot and a goal, maybe take the lead to 3-2 here in going into the half rather than 2-2. Really, Grand Valley has had the ball most of the half. And like I said, both goalies have been making unbelievable saves. So they got 59 seconds back up on the clock here. They're going to start this second quarter here. 59 seconds left, 2-2. Grand Valley State ball at the top of their box, getting ready to set up their clear, and the whistle's back in. So they're in a diamond clear here. Diamond clear. They're offsides. Offsides, and the refs pick up on it. There's 43 seconds left here.
Those mistakes.
So Stad picks it up.
Those mistakes can't happen. Here's Polka again. What a hustler. Just going to draw a flag on that. Should draw a flag on that.
No flag, coach. No flag on that. So we got Scad ball here.
I gotta agree with Coach Cummings a little bit on that one. I mean he split too, but he was certainly tripped up.
13 seconds left here. Scad playing defense. Grand Valley with the ball under 10, and here it comes down the other way. Let's see if we got something here. Ball's loose, and that's gonna end the half. 2-2. End of the half. Great goaltending on both parts. We will be back live from Greenville, South Carolina. I'm Coach Barrett, standing here with Coach Thurin, and we will be back. Enjoy the half. And we're back here live from Greenville, South Carolina at the Division II MCLA first round matchup between SCAD of Georgia and Grand Valley State of Michigan, 2-2 at halftime. And, you know, what we've seen in the first half is a flurry of shots and a lot of great saves and a lot of turnovers here in the middle of the field in the riding and clearing game. But what an exciting second half we're up to here with Coach Turin, and I'm Coach Barrett here in Greenville, South Carolina. Thank you to our sponsors, Lax World and the City of Greenville, for putting on such a great event.
You know, Coach Barrett, I'm looking forward to more of what we saw in the first half. With the up and down transition game was great. And just, I mean, like you said, with the goalie play being so good, this game could easily be a 10-10 game right now. These goalies have both just stood on their heads and made outstanding saves.
And here we go. First faceoff goes to Grand Valley. Get it to their short stick. They get a touch inside the box here, and they're going to be on the first possession here on offense. Grand Valley working the ball up top in their offense here. Number zero taking a big hard dodge, splits right to his left, comes to the middle field, and a shot
nice
and a
shot.
Goal to get Grand Valley on the board and take their first lead of the game, 3-2.
That Charlie Farmer's second goal of the game today, Coach. I believe that's Charlie Farmer's second goal of the game today, but what a just great split dodge from the top and finish from the inside.
Next faceoff here, let's see if Skag can come back and try to get this game tied up. Ball's loose, defensive end. Grand Valley picks it up, throws an errant pass, goes back to SCAD, and now SCAD's going to set up their offense here.
Sorry if you people at home heard that. Came down from the field. Can't control the weather, which is outstanding today, by the way. Got from up top right now, Shelton Polka with the ball.
His
brother's
hard.
Had an outstanding day in the cage.
Dodges hard to his left hand, comes back to his right. Still continues to hold on to the ball. Both defenders kind of go away. Comes back to the goal, come back to his right hand, keeps it in his stick. Throws a skip pass off a 13 stick. It's loose in the corner here. Hard check by Grand Valley State on his back. 13 with the ball and loses it out of bounds. Grand Valley State's going to pick it up, and they're going to be on the clear.
Just one too many turns on that one. Sometimes you got to attack that pressure, Coach, and not run away from it.
Yeah, Aaron Farabee just was in a little trouble there in the corner, and they just got the ball taken off of him. Good clear there by the goalie. And another turnover by Grand Valley, and here comes SCAD with the ball and gets knocked out. Loose on the sideline. Comes back into the middle of play. Picked up by 17, Grand Valley State. He pushes it to the goal. Dodging three guys. Ball is down. Goalie picks it up and hits a midi streaking, who can't handle it.
Can't have a better
and
pass
a great
than
exchange
that.
By a midi and a defenseman there. Picks it up, defenseman picks it up, pushes it down, and throws it away. And we're going to come on the clear for SCAD. Coach, both teams, again, just really throwing the ball away in this clearing game.
It's amazing, Coach. It's, you know, and unfortunately in the MCLA, we don't have media timeouts. But I bet you both coaches were wishing right now they could get a media timeout so they didn't have to waste one of their own to calm their guys down. But somebody may have to here.
21 just forces one, passes it out to the wing to 13, gets back up top to number 7. Here comes number 7, dodging hard from up top, splits left to right, comes down the alley, feeds inside, and the pass gets missed, and that's a feed, and that goes out of bounds, and that's going to be Grand Valley ball. So Michael McQuaid looking to feed inside the crease. They couldn't handle it, throws it out of bounds, and now we got Grand Valley on the clear.
If I'm McQuaid on that one, I don't want to be that too unselfish. Can you, Coach? I think that's a shot you got
to
take.
Yeah, I think he had a good look at the cage there, too, and just tried to get one a little bit closer and just was hard to handle inside. Here comes the goalie clearing it.
That's it.
Big overpass of defenseman number zero.
So now we got Charlie
he's
Farmer not only plays short stick, he plays long pole as well.
He's got it with the pole right here, and he hits the pipe. What a shot. With Charlie with the long pole hits the pipe, so he can bring it with the short stick and the long pole. What a dual threat. And
wow.
A great clear push transition, but a high shot for SCAD, and they pick up the ball at the end line. Quick restart. Going hard to the goal here, number two.
I tell you what, Brendan Mason saved that play. Just had a little lift at the end of that shot, Coach.
Now we got a 4-on-4 coming the other way. Grand Valley pushing it. 4-on-4. They swing it behind. A little slow break action up to the wing on 22. Grand Valley bench is screaming yellow, so they want to slow it down and get their subs on.
How impressive is Charlie Farmer?
He's
got this kid come out there with a short stick, and he's outstanding, and then puts a pole in his hand, and it looks like he owns it.
Absolutely. Now he's got a water bottle, sucking back the water to get himself some breath and get back out there. He's doing a great job for his team. Ball gets moved around. Up top to number 19. We got a pick coming across from 26. He dodges hard off of it to his right hand. Slide comes early. Recycle back to X. Ball gets in front to number 4. Back up top to 26. Up to number 11. Passes it behind. 22. Over to 42. They call out Siegel for one of their plays here. Let's see what they do. So it's a dodge at X in the invert. We got cutters off ball here. And a bad pass coming up top, coming to the SCAD attack. And now wow. Referee calls black on the line.
Wow.
He would have pushed a 3-on-2 the other way, but he takes it from him, and it goes to white.
I don't know about that one. I don't know if he was in position to make that call, Coach.
I think these coaches are a lot calmer than what Coach Barrett or Coach Turin would be on the sideline with some of these calls today.
For sure. I'd ask him to actually straighten that line out just a tad. And then make that call.
Ball gets moving around here. The Grand Valley on the offense. Good ball movement here. Ball gets up to number 11. Moves it off to the wing on 19. Back down to X at 4. And they got the invert again that they want. A lot of invert here so far. Here comes number 4 against the short stick. Number 18 behind. They got 5 in front of the cage. Dodges hard to his right hand. A lot of movement, feeds inside, and another pipe.
Another pipe
for Grand Valley. 22 hits that low corner on the pipe, and SCAD comes away with the rebound, and now they're setting up their clear.
Just unlucky. Number 4 for Grand Valley, Jeremy Poba, he's very unorthodox, but I tell you what, his feeds have been on point, and he's very done a tremendous job of finding guys inside. It's just... people just aren't finishing. Great hustle on the part of Josh Walters on that clear.
Another errant pass that gets thrown away and out of bounds. Coach, they're in. They keep working really hard to clear it, and then they just shoot themselves in the foot by throwing it away.
You know, and it's one of those situations, too, Chris, where you're in a situation where you don't even need to make the pass, and that's probably one of the more frustrating parts for the coaches is that when you don't need to make the pass, you're in no trouble. You know, just settle it on your own, and let some guys move to you.
Here comes number 2. Inside roll. Whoa. And a goal.
Oh, wow.
Do the referees throw a flag?
The flag?
They count the goal, and it's a hold. So the flag
is
wiped off, and we have a tie ball game at 3 apiece. Great inside roll by number 2 on the SCAD attack. C- Cody Sankiewicz with a great inside roll for the goal, the equalizer, to tie the game at three with 7:39 remaining here in the third quarter.
SCAD goes for number three, Andrew Vandenhoevel.
Here's the faceoff. Quick clamp by SCAD. Ball's loose on the wing. Picked up by number 10.
How about that?
There he is again, all over the field for SCAD.
Polka, again, it just
big cut
just
inside. Feed to number pole, the pole 31. Did a nice job getting it to his right hand, but a wide shot. Quick off the end line. Here comes number 2 again. Feeds in front. Ball gets deflected back down to the Grand Valley State attack. Great ground ball by number 4 on Grand Valley. A lot of pressure on him right now. 26 chasing his stick. He carries it down. Pushes it to X, who feeds in front, and the ball gets deflected to the goalie. And now we're out on the clear. Here comes Polka.
Polka to Polka. See if he can go coast to coast.
Polka carries it down to his offensive end, gets his touch in the box, and gets it up to his midfielder. 32-7-10 on the midfield for SCAD right now. Ball at number 2.
Guys are starting to stand with some flat feet, Coach, and that's when you can tell the guys are getting a little tired.
And it's been a lot up and down here. I mean, if I was a midi, I'd be tired today, too. I've been running up and down the field all day. Here comes balls up to 32. Big shot. Good deflection by the goalie and saved. So that goes wide, and now we got a inbounds here with SCAD. Number 7 picking it up.
Michael McQuaid, this is a good matchup right here. Michael's a
coming
very
hard
good
right-handed, big bounce shot, goal. Great save by the goalie. Ball was loose in front. I thought it was going to trickle in, but he great save and get it to the SCAD. SCAD had a great shot to the middle of the field there, but it gets back to Grand Valley State, and now they're back down on offensive end here. Both teams putting on the pressure offensively here, really making the goalies make some saves.
We had an offsides call, but the man was behind the referee, and I think the ref's going to correct the call and make it right now.
Okay, so the ball's going to stay a white interversion whistle there. They thought they had a late sub, but they didn't, so. Ball stays at Grand Valley. Here we go.
Yeah, I think Coach Tim Murray's got a point. This guy's had a break.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
He got taken away. And in a 3-3 ball game right now.
Here comes number 1, hard dives. Slide comes early. Moves it over to the other wing. Here comes number 4. Moves it down to the attack. Back over to number 12. Back up to number 1, the lefty. Comes hard in front to his right hand. Comes back to his left. He's going to take a shot. Great save by the SCAD goalkeeper.
Right off of his shaft. He saw it. He stepped to it right off his shaft.
Here comes number 12, dodging hard around. Here comes a double, quick double. Number 4 is inside, pops out, catches the ball, moves it right back down to 12.
This should be
up to 48 on.
Boy, I want him dodging the high side on that one. Maybe he didn't see what was there. Whoa.
Great
good,
grab
good
by there.
Number 12 is 7'2" on that one.
Here comes number 0. So he just had a long pull. Now he's has a short stick, and he's in the offensive set here. They're going big little behind, so trying to get a matchup on the short stick.
There's Farmer.
So they're attacking the short stick here. Feed up top to number 4. Shot saved by the SCAD goalkeeper. We have 4 minutes remaining here in the third quarter, and SCAD's on the clear. Aaron pass on the clear. Saved by the attackman. Passed up to 32. Ground ball. picked up again by Grand Valley. And here comes Grand Valley in transition.
No numbers here. You got a pole on you. That's the smart play, giving that ball up. Settle down. 3:38 left in the quarter. You guys have been up and down. I'd like to see a good possession, long possession here.
See what Grand Valley does. Both teams playing man-to-man right now. No zone this game.
A little slow subbing, which is smart.
Taking their time. Refs, they got their eyes on it here, waiting to see if there's going to be a stall call. They got their offensive unit on, so they should start making some attacks at the cage. Here's another errant pass. Ball gets loose towards the sideline. Pressure gets played all the way out. Goes
one-handed
for a swing check. Number 12 moves it back up top. I would expect a timer on here really soon. Here comes 19 hard down the alley. Rolls back to his right. Feeds it out to the wing. Number 4, throw down to the attack. Ball get moved around the outside. Number 11 dodges hard to his right hand. Moves it up top to 26. 26 back up to 11.
Done a good job of killing a minute so far right now, Coach.
Number 11, hard dodge to his right hand. Quick and early slide by SCAD. Good recovery.
Timer
is on. Here comes 19 over the top.
No.
Shot, save.
Oh, you're going to get a push from behind on this.
So there's a push from behind when the ball is loose, and now it's going to go Grand Valley ball on the outside.
Just one of those. Not a smart play. Your goalie's got the ball. You don't want to have that happen. You just played a minute and a half of defense, and to give it back to Grand Valley.
Top dodge hard for number 11. Comes back, rolls back to his left, throws it back up top. Grand Valley really having trouble penetrating to the middle of this defense here. Here's a short stick up top on an attackman, number 4. Feeds it over to number 11, throws it up to the wing, number 19. Shot and wide. Grand Valley with the backup.
I just don't like these long passes, Coach. I think it's having an effect on.
Quick and early slide again from the SCAD defense. Feed inside, number 4 catches and hits the pipe. Ball's loose in the corner, and that's going to stay with White off the shot back up. A minute and 15 seconds left here in the third quarter in a 3-3 ball game. Alley dodge, number 19, feeds in front. Nobody's there. Grand Valley comes up with the ground ball, keeps it on offense. Really long possession here, Coach. They've had
it
since the 3:30 mark.
It was actually about 3:50 when it started. And here's Polba, draws a double.
Inside roll, ball's loose. Number 11 can't hang on to it. Ball's still loose. Number 4 picks it up. 44 seconds left. Number 12 dodges through everybody's shot, and a goal.
Not
a lot of movement off ball, but he gets it done there with a big dodge to the middle of the field and a great goal.
Ripped the duck on that one. He just hit that top left corner. Just painted a pretty picture right there, Coach.
Jeremy Strunk. Nope, sorry, that was Brendan Austin. Brendan Austin with a great swim move to the middle of the field, sticks it high, gives Grand Valley the 4-3 lead with 31 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Much different contest from the 17-11 game earlier in the year, huh, Coach?
Yeah, this is unbelievable. It's been great goalie play, which has had an unbelievable effect. But the turnovers, and obviously not having the statistics from the first game, but I'd be curious to see if there was the amount of turnovers that we've had in this game that have created the alternate possessions as well.
Here comes Polka with a shot. That goes wide. And that's going to stay black with 3 seconds.
And the clock should be some time put back on that clock.
Well, it looks like 1 second. And that'll be the end of the third quarter. We have a 4-3 Grand Valley State lead over SCAD.
If you're Grand Valley State right now and you're just coming to that huddle and you just used three minutes and 50 seconds and got a goal at the end of with 20 seconds left of that quarter, coach. What great use of time and great effort after a couple shots and a couple big ground balls, especially by number four, Jeremy Poba, who came up big two times hitting a pipe
absolutely.
And getting the ground ball back.
I'm sitting here, I'm watching the SCAD huddle right now, and all the defensemen have water bottles. They're exhausted. They just played 3.5 minutes of defense, so I think SCAD really, especially to start this fourth quarter, needs to get this first ground ball and have a nice long possession. Even if they don't score, just take a couple minutes off the clock, give their defense a little bit of a breather, and then get back into it after that. So let's see how this fourth quarter starts. But not a lot of scoring. We got a lot of saves. We got a lot of pipes. And we got a lot of miscues in the open field here. So we'll see what comes about here in this fourth quarter. But winner moves on, loser goes home. So it should be an exciting final 15 minutes of play from Greenville, South Carolina, here at the MCLA Division II National Championship Tournament. So here we are, starting the third quarter. Now you got Charlie Farmer at the faceoff X. So we've seen him with a short stick playing offense and defense. We've seen him with a long pole, taking a shot with a long pole. And now he's out there facing off with a short stick to start the fourth quarter. So Grand Valley State is not holding back any punches. They're going with their guys to try to get this win. Off the faceoff, Grand Valley State comes away with possession. 4-3 ball game.
And that by Vanderveen right there on the ground ball and the execution to get that to the attack, that's what you want to see in the clearing game, which we haven't seen a lot of. We haven't seen a lot of delivery. We've seen a lot of long passes, coach, and that.
Yep.
And I just have to. That's got to account for a lot of what we've seen as far as in the turnover game today.
Absolutely. Here comes Charlie Farmer. Number zero with the short stick up top, dodges hard to his right hand. Gets a push on the back, loses the ball for a second, picks it back up. Coming hard to his left hand. He's got the whole middle of the field. Shot wide. That was a good look at the goal. That was
a good look right there.
Back up goes to Grand Valley.
Wow.
And what a great ball move. Ball started X, got it to the wing. Number one cut hard, left-handed catch, finish. Put Grand Valley up by 2. 5-3 Grand Valley State.
Connor Schwalm again, coach. Just an absolute lefty hand cannon.
That is the first time a team has been up by more than one goal all game, coach. First
right.
time we got a two-goal lead.
You can tell guys are just coming. They are selling out. Guys are coming off the field just dragging right now. And it's getting warm. It's.
I would say it's about 75 right now, coach.
I don't know. I got thick blood from upstate. I'm going to go with 80.
Okay.
I'm hot.
Regardless, it's definitely hot from the boys from Michigan.
Oh, absolutely.
Valley, you know? SCAD boys should be used to this. But right now, Grand Valley up by 2 with 13.5 to play in this game.
Here comes your three guns again. They're putting the top midfield out there again.
It's not a bad look. I mean, you get one more goal here, yep. you put them up 6-3. It might be a good move here because you're gonna have the second midfield come out, run the next possession, especially if you're up by 3 here. Aaron Pass, ball's loose up top. Number 9 picks it up off the ground. Farmer dodges to his left hand. comes back to his right, feeds inside the 12. Oh, great save.
Great
off
save.
The shoulder. The left shoulder of the goalie. Another point blank save.
Unbelievable.
Ball gets up top here.
Here goes Tyler Farmer on a run and see what he can do. Let's see. Nice, great dips and done. And another phenomenal save by Polka.
Unreal.
Wow. It just unbelievable. What an unbelievable game.
I tell you
this
what,
if
they make all tournament teams here, you're going to have a hell of a time finding a Division II goalie because I got two right here in front of me that are good. And we got more games to play, coach. Oh,
they're been outstanding, these two.
And there goes a bad pass by the goalie. That goes out of bounds. It's going to be a quick restart here for Grand Valley.
Unfortunately, there's no balls up here. Yep.
Whistle good's blown in. Grand Valley with their second midfield out there right now, giving their first a break. Under 12 minutes to play in this game. 5-3 Grand Valley. Ball getting moved around the offense here. Grand Valley really taking their time. Here comes number 19. He's passing it around. No pressure by SCAD yet. Just letting them move the ball around.
They're pushing. They're pushing out and they're making the passes long. And this is what I don't like, coach. This is what happens.
Here
you
it
got
is.
All this space, and here comes Polka.
He's got great a ground little ball. Bit of a, he's pushing transition, coming over to his left hand, stops, pulls it out.
I don't want to be shooting at this guy, at this guy's feet. Danny Kranzberger, the goalie from Grand Valley, I don't want to be shooting at his feet. He's been eating him up all game long. We got a timeout here by SCAD. It's probably not a bad call right now. They could use a little break. They could use a little calming down right now. We got plenty of time left. It's a two-goal game and 11 minutes left in this game. Coach, plenty of time, and I think this is a great timeout right now for Coach Cummings, just to get his team to calm down a little bit on offense and just tell them there's no urgency right now. You just got to chip them one at a time.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you come out here, you run a good offensive possession, you score a goal, you're down one. And this is a game of runs here where two goals, you know, 10:48 left. I mean, this is plenty of time. And you know, so SCAD's still got everything in front of them. You know, they just got to start chipping away here.
Yeah, I mean, you're down two goals, and you've literally played three quarters of the game on defense. I would not be in any sense of urgency right now. I would actually take the longest possession that I can right now before I get into my set offense where I'm looking to score.
So let's see what SCAD does here coming out of the timeout with the ball. 10:48 left in the fourth quarter, down 5-3. SCAD, number two, starting with the ball in the low left corner here. Everybody's in there and matched up. Referee's getting ready to start play. And here we go. So let's see what SCAD comes out of here at a timeout. Ball gets up to number 18 up top. Looks like they're in a 1-4-1.
Right out of it. And
he's got the whole middle field. Quick and early slide. He keeps the ball.
And they went
for it up to Palco.
The mumbo right away, and it wasn't there. But smart enough to back it out and try it again. It looks like they're going to go out of that 14 and try that mumbo again.
Here comes number 10, hard dodge, comes back to his left, he's got a lot of lane, looks
there
inside,
oh,
and number
boy.
Two just misses wide.
Wow.
Great look. He was on the doorstep and just misses wide.
Cody
and they feed
Sikinowicz
inside again, and a great save by the goalkeeper. We got a flag,
got a flag
is down.
Down. I think we're going to get a push from behind 30 seconds on this one.
Cross
coach.
Check 1 minute. So
wow.
This is a huge opportunity for SCAD right now to be on extra man to see if they can bring this game to within one.
That's our first contact foul of the game today, and this has been a pretty aggressive game, Coach.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you know, we got guys selling out everywhere. We're in a national championship tournament. You know, guys are really selling out here. So let's see, extra man here. They're in a 3-3, moving the ball around. Not a lot of pressure from the SCAD defense.
I like that right wing over there.
SCAD offense here is moving it. Grand Valley comes up, moving it again. Yep. Looking for that backside guy, big bounce
boy.
Pass, and that goes out of bounds. So we're going to have a man down clear, Grand Valley State.
See, so you got time right now. Now's the time. Now's the time to throw out something different. Just throw out a little 10-man right here. You got your man up, so it's not even a true 10-man. You're not sacrificing the goal.
Charlie Farmer started with the ball, short stick down low. Now it gets back to the goalie. Gets up to 34 here at the midfield line. He's going to carry. He's got a long pole on him. Tough matchup. Ball is down on the sideline here. Fighting for the loose ball. Gets kicked out. Grand Valley comes away with it and possesses
Tyler,
here.
Tyler Farmer comes up with the big ground ball. The brothers are doing a lot of work out here today.
Absolutely. Here's up to Charlie here. Ball's up top, gets down to the low wing here, gets back up top. So Coach Serena, I would expect that maybe the next time down, SCAD's going to have to start putting a little bit more pressure here to start getting some turnovers. Ball gets moving. Number 12, wide open.
Great save
by the goalkeeper again. Rebound gets picked up by Grand Valley. Pushed over to the backside, 42 has it. Takes it back to X, slows it down again.
If I'm SCAD right now, I want to push out on these minis, and I want to make their attack go and carry. Their attack.
Here comes number one, hard down the left-handed alley. He's got a shot, and right into the goalie's stick. So SCAD needs to break out the clear, and the goalie just throws it ahead of the midi, and it's rolling up by the midfield line now. Loose ball picked up by SCAD. He pushes it. Just a lot of unforced errors right here, right now.
Yeah.
Ball's loose in the back corner. Defender picks it up.
Just
for Grand Valley. Goalie's on the end line. He picks it up, and now Grand Valley's going to run their clear, coming back down the other way.
Just guys just overthinking and thinking that they have to make a play right now because it's a broken situation. Yeah, it's, you know, there's plenty of time left, and you just got to value that ball. That's
getting close to about 7.5 minutes here. Grand Valley carries it over the midfield line, gets a touch in the box, gets it up to Charlie Farmer, gets a touch, moves it over to number one. A lot more poise on the offensive end for Grand Valley right now. It's really taking their time.
It's been...
Feed inside the number 12. Shot and a goal.
Great shot.
Put them up 6-3 with 7 minutes and 9 seconds remaining. They double up the score here to make it 6-3.
Yeah, Brendan Austin coming flashing through the middle again. It's his just almost looked exactly like his last goal.
You could hear the crowd roaring up in Cayuga on that one, Coach.
Concordia 8, and updates from the other fields. six, SCAD three.
Got our second midfield group out here right now for Grand Valley.
So here's the pressure that I was expecting from SCAD. Now they're starting to pressure all over the field, down three goals. They put the ball on the ground. Here comes a big ground ball from SCAD. It gets laid out. Ball is down. He still has the ball, Coach. Now as the ball's down, Grand Valley picks it up, and they're going to look to settle it down here. Up three goals. You got 6 minutes and a change left in the game. 6-3 contest.
They just can't allow the midfielders to stand out there and play catch. I want the ball with the attack, and then I want it, those middies shut off, because the attack hasn't proven to me today that they can really break down a guy one on one.
Great feed inside. Another outstanding save by the goalkeeper. Number four is going to pick it up off the end line here. We're down to 5:50 in this game. 5:50 left in this game.
Now you're starting to see. Trying to close the middies off.
So they're going into invert again. White's in the invert. Not a lot of chatter on this SCAD bench here. Here comes a big dodge. Going to his left-handed X, comes back to his right, feeds in front to number 12, who hangs his stick, gets trail check, balls down in the middle of the field. Grand Valley comes away with it, and moves it down, carries it to X, and they just keep possession of the ball here. Right back down to X again, they're holding on to it. Really understanding that they're up three, short time, not forcing it. Really taking their time, possession on offense here. Here comes number 19 around, right-handed, hits the pipe. Rebound in front, 42 picks it up. High hit. It was a high hit there, and we're going to have an extra man opportunity here for Grand Valley. So another opportunity for them to have the ball for another minute and see if they can put it up by four. 1 minute check by 16, 1 minute foul. Here's the extra man opportunity again for Grand Valley. 6-3 lead, 4:45 left in this game. Winner moves on to the second round, loser is out. And again, remember, these two teams faced off in Florida early in the season with Grand Valley winning 17-11. And we have a 6-3 game here in the playoffs, so.
By no means is 6-3 indicative of how exciting this game has been.
No.
This has been a great game to watch. It's just been up and down.
About eight pipes combined. I would say there's at least a good solid 18 saves combined. There's a lot of action in this game right now. So let's see how this one finishes out here. We're at 4:24 left in the quarter. Yeah. Pass to the backside. Extra man. Good skip pass. Great face dodge by Farmer. Great save by the goalkeeper.
Boy, oh boy. He's unbelievable how quickly he gets down to the ball. And a smart play. I mean, it's just a little hard, but.
Loose ball in the corner. We got a couple guys going after it. Grand Valley comes up with it. That's not what SCAD needed right there, Coach. They really needed to clear that one.
Yeah.
And here's 3:45 left in the quarter. 6-3, Grand Valley State with the lead and the ball.
A little quick to send their shorties off on that one, and left it in with the poles in the poles' hands, and it made things a little difficult.
Number four keeps it, feeds inside. Number nine, another save by the goalkeeper, Coach Duran. Point blank save.
It's like a concrete wall beneath that boy, beneath Polka's knees. He's just not scoring down there. He just gets down to that ball. He reads it so well. It's been the high heat that's gotten him. They just haven't beaten him down low.
Grand Valley with the invert has the ball at X. Here comes Charlie Farmer to his right. Stops, comes back to his right. To his left again, feeds inside. There's number four. He handled, and another save by the goalkeeper.
Once again, right at his feet. And you know, if I'm If I'm
SCAD's coming down, clearing the ball, they need one here, Coach Thurin. They really need one here to make this a two-goal game.
I'd almost use my last timeout right now, Coach, just because I just want to make sure that I get my guys out there. I got fresh legs. We have a clear plan of what we need to do.
There needs to be a little bit more of a sense of urgency here on the offensive end. I mean, they're really taking their time. They got guys walking on and off the field here, subbing. And, you know, they're down three, and they're under 3 minutes to go. There's 2.5. Wow. There's a flag. Flag is down, and here comes Polka around. He fakes low, sticks it high. The flag is waved off, and we have a 6-4 ball game with 2:20 left in the fourth quarter.
Great individual dodge effort by Polka on the pole. Gets the flag, runs right through the check to the head, and dips and dumps a shot right over the goalie stick.
And he comes to the bench, and he goes right to the front of the line at the box because he wants back out there. He knows there's a lot of left in this game, and he wants back out there. 6-4, 2:20 remaining. Grand Valley State with a two-goal lead. Here's a ground ball. And Grand Valley picks it up off the wing. 17. Here comes SCAD. Avoids the big hit.
Boy,
and pushes it. Let's see what they got here. Ball moves down to number 10. Polka again with the ball at X. Comes back to his right hand. Feed.
Boy, oh boy.
And that goes out of bounds, and we're going to go Grand Valley ball. That was tough right there. They really needed to hang on to that one because that would have gave
us
a good look.
I'm calling a timeout right now, and it's unfortunate because right now it's 10-man ride time.
They got to ride this ball and get this ball back. We're getting close to about a minute and a half left in this ball game. It's a 6-4 Grand Valley lead. We got a deep ride here from Savannah. Man streaking over, get it to an attackman, and that's an easy clear right there. That defenseman should have been on its attackman there. You don't like to see that. Minute and 20 left in the game. 6-4 Grand Valley State lead. And they're going to look to try to ice the ball. They got double teams sending out everywhere for SCAD. The goalie's out of the cage, and they are trying to make things happen defensively here. Ball's behind. Again, they set the double out. They got the goalie trying to guard the closest guy to the crease. Goalie's back in the cage now. Savannah trying to put the pressure on now. Grand Valley doing a nice job. Throws the ball away.
All right.
And that's going to be SCAD ball here with 42 seconds left. Let's see if they can make something happen here, Coach Thurin. They got to make it. They got to go to the goal hard. Let's go. You can't waste time. Here comes the clear. Number 7 with the ball. He's got 33 seconds left, 6-4 game. Grand Valley forcing him down the side.
McQuaid showed he's able to get to the cage before, but he's
number 7.
Go.
20
no
seconds
time.
Now. Feed inside the number 13, shot, and
a goal.
With 17 seconds remaining to make it 6-5 Grand Valley State. This next face-off is gigantic, Coach Thurin.
Gigantic, and what a great finish by Farabee. What a great pass and a great finish by Farabee. But I tell you what, that all started with a hard dodge from Mike McQuaid and just a tremendous finish. And it all, I mean, the game, this is the game right
here
now.
Here it is, 6-5, 17 seconds left. Here's a faceoff. Polka on the wing for SCAD. We got the faceoff going on. Refs about to bring the players down. 17 seconds left. Here comes the faceoff. Ball's out.
We're gonna get a push from behind and going SCAD's way.
And we got SCAD ball with 11
SCAD
seconds left here. Polka with the ball. He's going to the goal. Save. Ball's loose in front. 3-2-1 And that is the game. Grand Valley State hangs on for the one goal victory, 6-5. Thank you for being with us here. What an excellent first-round game.
Great first-round game. If that's indicative, Coach, of what we're going to see through the rest of the tournament, this is going to be a great, great day tomorrow for Division II MCLA lacrosse.
Well, thank you so much for joining us here from live from Greenville, South Carolina. Again, Grand Valley State 6, Savannah School Art and Design 5. We will be back with you later on with the afternoon games. Thank you.